When were the seeds planted for the reunion? You know, 2010 happened, there was a hiatus, which is the only word we ever use when bands take a break. I don't think we use that word in any other context.
Well, we split up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it wasn't really, yeah. Yeah, we called it a day.
Sarah Champion, backstage at the Isle of Wight Festival. It is day three, and we welcome to the Isle Supergrass. Welcome back, in fact.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, we've been here before.
2005?
Yeah.
Does that sound right?
I think so, yeah.
How many years is that?
Well, that's 15 years, 16 years, yeah. It's crazy, isn't it? Well, yeah, it's great to be back.
I do feel like time has warped in the last sort of 18 months, so you're quite right to go, how long ago was that? I don't remember. Yeah. It's all slightly strange, isn't it? Of course, you were originally set to play last year. How kind of far advanced preparations-wise were you before you knew that, obviously, it wasn't happening?
Ooh, I don't know. I mean, we were ready to go on everything, really.
Yeah.
But a lot of it got moved, you know, obviously, much like everybody else. It was a shame because we were up and running. We were sort of kind of on fire, you know.
You thought, is this going to last 3 months? And then it went 6 months, and then it's next year.
Yeah.
It's just continually moving. So it's just, you know, playing it by ear, really.
James said on Friday there was sort of almost a point that they thought they would just never get on stage
ever again.
Did you feel the same way?
We've got a funny manager who's kind of very sure of a lot of things, and he's kind of he seemed to be quite certain of a few things here and there. But it was more maybe is anything going to be this year? I think that was definitely that thought, because so much was being moved to 22, and so when things picked up, you know, when a couple of them started being able to operate, it was kind of, yeah, I think that was a bit of a surprise.
Mm.
But brilliant, you know, brilliant to sort of be out there. I think we did Latitude as probably one of our first ones back this year, and it was amazing.
It was euphoric.
You know, the kind of atmosphere and the release from everybody, and I think us on stage as well, it was quite sort of overwhelming. Yeah,
release is a really good word, I think, because it's almost like we've sort of got this pent up energy, this will to want to scream and shout in a field and dance.
Yeah,
and
yeah, yeah.
This primal need.
It is, yeah, totally. So it's great, yeah, great when you see everybody kind of going nuts, because yeah, there are little thoughts across your mind, like, you know, what about crowd surf? Are people going to crowd surf mosh pits and stuff? But it, I mean, everything's just moved on and evolved from being able to get the vaccines, I suppose. It's amazing to see everything up and running.
Because I guess last year for you would have marked, is it 25 years since Aisha Coco? It's the 25th anniversary, would have been last year, right?
Well, I don't know, we're not that up on looking that hard back and working it out
numerically
and stuff. But yeah, it's been a long time.
I'm genuinely only bringing that up because when I first worked in radio and we'd do kind of guess the years, I was always genuinely fascinated that people could pinpoint an exact year from a song. Mm. And now for me, songs off of that album, I go, oh, that's summer 1995, because I was at university, it was my first year. I remember jumping, you know, pogoing around the dance floor to that.
Yeah, I did, from when my kids were born. I mean, my daughter was born the year Aisha Coco came out, so that's how I know how long ago. Yeah, it's 26 years.
Yeah, I think music, like nothing else, can take you back to that specific moment in time as well.
Yeah, but whether you can actually name the year, it's just some pong in the past a long time ago.
Especially after the year we've just had, I mean, who knows? When were the seeds planted for the reunion? You know, 2010 happened, there was a hiatus, which is the only word we ever use when bands take a break. I don't think we use that word in any other context.
Well, we split up.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. So it wasn't really, we called it a day. We were all of the mindset that you just never know what happens. We didn't split up sort of, you know, trying to rip each other apart, which was probably a good thing. There was always a possibility that something could happen, and you know, when you kind of mark the special dates or the anniversaries, you never know, there's always an option. So I think when it came around, we just a couple of phone calls, there was a few people interested in helping us out with it and trying to make it work, the reunion, and then we just chatted on the phone and just sort of thought, yeah,
I was actually in the middle of the desert in Australia when I got that call.
It was quite interesting.
Oh, were you really?
Yeah, I went out to see Uluru and right out in the desert, and I just had the phone call, just sort of trying to get reception in the middle of the desert, and do you want to get the band back together?
Was it a spiritual experience?
It was quite nice.
I was in the bath.
Were
you? Yeah, it was also a spiritual experience. Well, for a different reason. You think, sod it, yeah, let's get in a room and rehearse and see what happens, see how it feels. And I think after the first rehearsal we knew that we still had it. We still got
maybe
it.
By the second or third one, maybe.
Yeah, it's a great thing to mark the sort of, you know, all the great records that we did and all those great singles that we released. Now feels like a good time. I think we might be getting a bit old if we leave it any longer. You know, kind of in our sort of mid-late 50s playing all right and, you know, punk rock and roll songs. I don't know.
Duran Duran are doing all right, though, aren't they?
Yeah, but they've got 10 years on us. Got that sort of, you know, space in the music. It's not like, I always think about that if you were like a punk band. It's kind of hard
well,
in your 50s
exactly
and 60s.
Right,
you know,
right, right.
We're young enough at the moment.
Yeah.
To kind of deliver it with some swagger.
Yeah, we can still dance. We just, you know, maybe not for quite as long and we might need a rest afterwards.
Yeah, we put a little segue in the middle of the set.
Toilet break, yeah.
Yeah, just to kind of get some oxygen.
Danny was going to feign injury at one point
yeah
in the set, wasn't he? Around song 10 or 11.
Yeah, a bit like time wasting when you're a goal up and you just want to kind of kill
play
5 minutes.
Play for time.
Yeah, play for time. But yeah, we're doing good. We've got a lot of energy for it and it's feeling great.
And going forward, you've got a few gigs lined up as well. Is it December?
We've got a lot of the gigs that we kind of sold in 2020. We've
yeah,
got to go back none of those. I mean, there's festivals next year as well. And just whatever comes up in the meantime as well, you know, kind of yeah up for it all.
Brixton December will be brilliant, 19th, 20th of December. So that'll be a cracker. It was always a bit of a special gig, Brixton.
And while you're here, are you going to kind of stick around and, you know, enjoy all the fun of the festival?
Yeah.
Some of it, yeah.
Yeah. Well, I don't feel like sitting in a room.
No.
Although there might be a bit of that.
Yeah, watching Columbo earlier.
We were watching Columbo about an hour ago. It was a good episode.
It'd be good to go out and check out a few of the other bands and maybe catch Duran Duran, who, you know, I've never seen him play live before. I think I bought Rio in 1983, so it'd be nice to see him.
Was it 1983, though?
Yeah, it was.
Was it?
I was.
What do you remember about it?
Well, I was only about 13, but yeah, I remember it being, you know, sort of that biggest record that year, so it'd be great to see that.
What about Paul Young?
84.
Wherever, yeah, I was going to say 84.
Was that 82?
It might have been. It was a bit earlier 80s, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I remember buying Paul Young, Wherever I Lay My
Hat.
That's
my home.
I bought that
bracket
in a French supermarket.
No Parley.
Yes.
Yep.
So there we go.
Had that on the C90.
Let's play Guess the Year.